You're so evil!
No matter how many times I see it, it's such bad taste. The worst, the lowest, most brutal taste. Somehow I moved my muscles, stiff from fear and nerves, and awkwardly walked onto the escalator. For some reason, my breathing was short, and I was eventually struck by a feeling similar to dizziness. The moment all of us were inside Monokuma Rock. A rumbling sound filled the room, and the surrounding space began to fall. As it shook with clatter, the elevator we were inside continued to drop. Throughout that drop, I was fluctuating between feeling hope and despair, as if my heart was rotten fruit, swelling in the sun before it finally goes squish. I suddenly stopped breathing. Oh crap, my consciousness began to fade from the pressure. I tried to endure that pressure by firmly standing on my legs. And after a while, the elevated vibrations gradually weakened. And it stopped altogether. Aang! Defeat the boring routine!
So
I've decided to start redecorating. How's it look? Mr. Monokuma's redecoration is awesome, isn't it? It's not like I'd allow you to think otherwise anyway.
That is...
To go through the trouble of doing something this elaborate. Really, what is your true intention?
No.
Nothing really. Essentially, this killing game is just to kill time anyway. Kill time?
Yeah!
To break away from my purpose. That alone is my purpose.
Like...
A purpose is only gonna be a weakness. Those who have purpose are always the weakest ones in the bunch. That's why you guys should forget about such cheap purposes like trying to survive. And enjoy the class trial from the bottom of your hearts. It's starting. The class trial is starting. No! Mairu Koizumi, the ultimate photographer. She had an unyielding force of personality, but she was actually very good at taking care of people. Most importantly, she was always straightforward. The person that killed her is among us. I don't want to believe it, but regardless, we need to find the answer. Doesn't matter if you believe it or not, because it's the only way. Aside from finding out who the killer is, there's no other way for us to survive. And so this life-threatening trial, billowing with hope and despair, has begun. What's up, gang? This is KenZerk, 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 and we're back on Danganronpa. I never really stopped recording, I just kind of kept it going. Ooh, what's this? Alright, let's get into the class trial. All right!
Now then, let's begin with a simple explanation of the class trial. During the class trial, you will present your arguments for who the killer is and vote for who done it. If you vote correctly, then only the blackened will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong person, I'll punish everyone besides the blackened, and that person will earn the right to leave this island.
Oh, no matter how many times I hear it, it's such a cruel rule.
Now then, let's first discuss the motive. That masterpiece of gaming, Twilight Syndrome Murder Case.
What? Who cares about that game?
The outcome of this trial should be determined by whether or not we find Mahiru's killer.
The game is important to the case, though.
Nevertheless, we shouldn't ignore it. After all, that game is the motive this time.
Yeah, you're right. Then let's try discussing that first.
I'm sure everyone who's beaten the game already knows that it's based on an actual murder case.
Some of us have not beaten that game. Give us a detailed explanation.
It means Twilight Syndrome Murder Case is a non-fiction game. Additionally, some of us are characters in that game too.
Some of us are characters in a video game?
So...
I think it's better if we clarify who the characters in the game are first.
Characters in the game. High school girl that got killed in the beginning. By using the staff role after clearing the game as a reference, I should be able to figure out who's who. First character the player was able to control was Girl A. The true identity of Girl A is Mikan.
I see. Girl A is probably Mikan Tsumiki. That timid tone. That definitely sounds like Girl A. Based on the list of names in the staff roll, I can't think of anyone else who would be Girl A.
Why am I in a video game? That's an infringement of my right to privacy.
Ha! A nasty, trashy pig shit like you doesn't have any privacy rights.
I knew she'd say it.
A nasty, trashy pig shit. I feel like I heard that in the game too.
Huh?
Character said that was Girl B.
I see. Girl B was short and foul-mouthed. She's probably Hyoko.
Short and foul-mouthed? That's like the complete opposite of me.
No.
Anyway, let's move on. Next is Girl C.
I paid no attention to Girl C, I'm not gonna lie. Hyper energetic and unique. Oh yeah, that's Ibuki.
I see. Girl C is Ibuki.
Girl C? Then I'll see you next Tuesday.
Let's move on to Girl D.
She did not like that joke. One person always had a camera with them. Mahiru.
Girl D is Mahiru, the victim in this case. Yeah, that's correct. Let's skip Girl E and talk about Guy F. I see! Aren't you Guy F, Fuyuhiko?
Huh. I was in a game? That's fucking stupid.
That reminds me. Wasn't there another person whose last name was also Kuzuryu? Another person? It was one of the names on the staff roll. The names were Tsumiki, Koizumi,
Sayonji, his little sister,
Miyota, Sato, Kuzuryu, and then another Kuzuryu.
Hold on. Why do you keep saying there were two Kuzuryus?
It's not like I'm wrong. That's how it's written on the staff roll. Since you beat the game, you probably know what this actually means, right?
Reason Fuyuhiko's last name Kuzuryu appears twice. It's true I have a hunch, but to call me out like that, Nagito, you're definitely someone I shouldn't mess with. It's cause he had a little sister.
I can prove it with this. In the game, Guy F, Kuzuryu, mentions that he has a little sister.
What do you mean, little sister?
This is what Guy F said in the game. It's pretty clear. There's no doubt that Guy F had a little sister. Plus, the sister actually appeared in the game. That's why the name Kuzuryu appeared twice.
By the way, what role did Guy F's little sister, the other Kuzuryu, play? You probably noticed, right?
I don't really want to say it myself, but I need to move the conversation forward. The girl who died.
The dead high school girl who was the first victim in the game is the only person I can think of.
Based on Guy F's tone in the game, it's clear that Girl E is not his little sister. So if the only person left is the dead high school girl, then she must be Fuyuhiko's sister.
Why do you sound so fucking happy? That's a winning personality you got there.
Winning personality? Are you praising me?
He looks so insane!
I was being sarcastic, dumbass.
Hey, you said the game is a work of nonfiction. That means Fuyuhiko's little sister is...
Yeah, I have a little sister. Something wrong with that? It's just a fucking game. Don't go mixing up some video game with reality. It's not just a game.
It's definitely based on true events. That's why it's the bogey. Don't go making shit up, bastard! If she was the type to die easily, I'd have fucking killed her myself a long time ago. I mean, when I first entered Hope Speak Academy, she was mouthing off to me, as usual, and sent me off. It happened just the other day.
About that. You're probably thinking like that because you've lost your memories.
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up! You be quiet!
Watch your mouth.
I see. So you're never gonna accept that that game is based on true events, huh? Okay, I understand your attitude toward this class trial now.
Nagito, you seem to be doubting Fuyuhiko a lot. Do you suspect he's the killer?
A mystery that easy would make me feel sad. It wouldn't be good enough to serve as everyone's stepping stone. That's why I'd be much happier if Fuyuhiko wasn't the killer.
Okay, you're starting to act weird again.
Anyway, now we've established who all the characters in the game are.
Girl A is Mikan. Girl B is Hiyoko. Girl C is Ibuki. Girl D is Mahiru. Guy F is Fuyuhiko. And the first victim in the game, that dead high school girl, is Fuyuhiko's little sister.
That's just a story in a fucking game.
Cat!
If so,
your sister dad cry about it.
Is Miss Sato.
Could it be? The same Miss Sato who likes white rice?
Who is Sato?
I don't know what Sato you're talking about, but I don't think she's relevant to this case.
Maybe it's related to Gundam's last name, since they're both really plain names.
What the heck? Is that wild connection?
Maka may be an ordinary family name, but it's far better than Sato or Suzuki.
And he also has a strange rivalry going on.
Hey, no one cares about that. Hurry up and talk about the mystery of the game.
Huh? What do you mean, mystery of the game?
My, my, you don't know. I heard that girl E got killed.
What? No way. Is that true?
Getting killed is so violent, don't you know?
My, such awful times we live in. Why did this happen?
You guys are definitely friends.
Yeah, bro.
So the mystery of the game is the murder of girl E, correct?
Then let's hurry up and solve it. Let's first figure out why girl E was killed.
The reason girl E was killed... because girl E was the killer.
I see.
The reason girl E was killed is because she killed the first victim in the game.
Which means girl E was killed as revenge for the dead high school girl. What do you think, Fuyuhiko? Apparently girl E was killed to avenge your little sister.
You're fucking persistent. I don't care what that game said at all.
But... Is that true? Girl E, she killed the first victim?
In order to make that clear, we need to know more about the case involving the first victim's murder.
It's the murder that occurred in the music room. I knew it would come up, so I prepared in advance. Look, I made a map of the music room's surroundings, which was okay. The stage of the first case.
I'm surprised you went to all this trouble.
Mapping is second nature to retro game fans. Classic dungeon crawler RPGs have a first-person point of view, so mapping as you play is a basic.
We get it! Let's talk about that later so we can focus on the case.
Then, I'll start explaining.
Okay.
Girl A, girl B, girl C, and girl D were at the entrance hall when they heard the sound of glass breaking. Immediately, they climbed the stairs to the second floor and headed to where they heard that sound. Girl E was in front of the music room on the second floor, and she confirmed that the sound came from in there. But the door to the music room was locked. So girl D went to get the key from the office, and when the five of them were finally able to go inside, they found the victim's body, dead from a blow to the head. Because the music room's window was broken, the girls thought the killer escaped through there, The sound of breaking glass that they heard at the entrance hall seemed to confirm that. Plus, Girl E's school swimsuit was stolen, so they concluded that the escape killer was some pervert. How does that sound?
Yep, an understandable explanation. Just as expected from the ultimate gamer who excels at clearing games.
But it wasn't a pervert, right? Wasn't the real killer Girl E?
Obviously. Girl E was waiting outside the music room for the other girls after she killed the first victim.
Did she lock the music room from the outside? Then she would have totally needed the key from the office.
Which means Girl E was hiding that key. We can assume she used it to lock the music room after she left it.
But Girl D was the one who went to the office to get the key to the music room, right?
By the way, since it was never mentioned in the game, we can exclude the possibility of there being a spare key.
You can lock the music room from the inside, right? So from there, Girl E broke the window and escaped and sprinted at the front of the music room as fast as she could before the others arrived.
I doubt she'd be that fast.
She would have passed by the entrance hall where the other girls were waiting if she tried to do that.
Then forget this.
It's not cute to see an old guy sulk.
Hey, is Girl E really the killer? We haven't reached an answer yet.
Based on the details of the game, there's no mistake that Girl E, who was waiting in the hallway, is a killer. But what did Girl E do after killing the girl inside the music room? Guess I need to clear that up first.
After she killed the first victim in the music room, what did Girl E do?
She just broke the window in the music room and escaped outside.
So how did Girl E get from outside the school to the front of the music room?
I don't know.
To go back to the music room from outside,
did she jump?
You need to go through the entrance hall.
Plus, at the entrance hall, the other four girls should have been there.
At the entrance hall, the girls heard the sound of the window shattering.
No, that's wrong.
First of all, the sound the girls heard wasn't the window breaking.
If it wasn't the window, then what broke to make that sound?
A vase.
Vase? How low can you go?
After the murder, a broken vase was discovered in the classroom next to the music room.
Okay.
So the sound of breaking glass that the four girls heard wasn't the music room's window.
Yeah?
It was the sound of the vase breaking. Probably.
Actually, the murder was nearly finished by the time the four girls met in the entrance hall. Girl E killed the victim in the music room, broke the window, and went to the office to get the key. With that key, she locked the music room from the hallway, returned the key to the office, and went back to wait in front of the music room. All she had to do was break the vase in the next door classroom as the four girls met by the entrance hall.
To make them think the murder had just occurred and that the killer had just escaped.
Oh.
So, when the four of them ran over after they heard the sound, Girl E acted like she had just rushed over too.
I see. Now the mystery has been solved.
Wait a minute! The mystery hasn't been solved yet! You haven't determined what the murder weapon was yet!
Murder weapon?
Who cares about the murder weapon? We found out who the killer was!
Not cool! I went to all the trouble of making this death march, so you gotta stick with it to the end!
Nobody asked you!
What the heck? You're so annoying!
Fine, let's figure out the weapon. If this keeps up, I'm gonna feel like I need to shit. Which means I'll feel disgusting!
You're the disgusting one!
Facts!
The weapon is pretty unconventional! The answer was revealed in the game, though!
Probably the fish tank.
Now then, will you guys be able to figure it out?
Unconventional weapon that also appeared in the game. If you can't advance on us, we didn't have to do it, I'll do it. What do you think the weapon is? I have no idea. Was I at a launch just now? tell you about white noise. Some white noise are actually very durable. You'll be able to destroy them in one shot. Durable white noise will chip away every time you shoot them with a silencer. Alright, I got it, bro. I got it. Yeah, it's a fish tank. It's a fish tank.
A weapon inside the music room, huh? What about broken glass?
Isn't the cause of death a blow to the head?
Think you talked her with the fish tank.
Come on.
That's too big to be a weapon.
Then the piano.
It's what?
Why are you going even bigger?
The investigation conducts universal chaos.
It's on that big a scale too?
How about beating her with gravel instead?
If it's a weapon that was used to beat them to death, it should have had blood stains.
Was there a weapon with blood stains on it?
She beat her to death with her fists!
We will never give up!
This does not make sense! I'm sorry, I really don't get it. I don't get it. I'm not comprehending.
What about broken glass?
Okay, broken glass.
Isn't the cause of death a blow?
It's a blow to the head.
You talked her with the fish tank.
That's a possibility.
That's too big to be a weapon.
But that's a possibility, but when I shot it with the fish tank to agree, boom, boom, it didn't freaking work. So what? I'm gonna try shooting it with this. I'm gonna try shooting it with this. Of course. Because it doesn't freaking work. Because it doesn't freaking work. I'm not understanding!
Investigation. It's on that biggest.
How about beating her with gravel instead?
Why does that work?
Killer must have used gravel to attack the victim.
Ha!
My goodness. I got it right. And I was just throwing things out there.
Doesn't make sense!
Just as I thought, I'm chosen by the god!
I'm sitting here stressing over what the answer is. I'm over here shooting truth bullets that make actual sense. But the right one is the stupidest one.
You're not chosen at all. And gravel is impossible. It's too small to be a weapon.
I need an explanation. I need an explanation.
What if the gravel is put inside some sort of bag? If the weapon is something that appeared in the game, then so is the bag. And the only thing I can think of is the school swimsuit.
I don't see any gravel inside that swimsuit. I don't see any remnants of gravel in that swimsuit. Oh, actually, hold on. That might be why he stole the swimsuit. Okay. I see what he's trying to cook up. That's just so stupid, though. How did you expect me to know that? For real. Like, that's so out of left field. There was no possible way you could have expected me to grasp that without losing 30 freaking times and figuring it out by chance.
If you tie the swimsuit like a bag and stuff it full of gravel, it'd make an effective weapon.
Gravel inside the swimsuit? Even the Ace Attorney would be astonished by such a fantastic idea!
But for the killer, it's an idea that kills two birds with one stone. To make people think the killer is some pervert, it makes sense for a school swimsuit to be stolen. And if that swimsuit was used to make an improvised weapon, it'd have to be disposed of later.
How about it, Monokuma? Are you satisfied now?
This happiness you feel when the mystery you create is solved. Only producers know this feeling of ecstasy.
But the real important talk begins now. Girl E had someone who can be called an accomplice. That person was actually Girl D.
Girl D. You're talking about Mahiru, right?
Huh? Mahiru is the accomplice? What is this? What does that mean?
The piece of face that became an important clue in the music room murder. Girl D got rid of it.
And
apparently the reason Girl E committed murder in the first place was to protect Girl D. Girl D was being harassed by the victim. Girl E found out and tried to stop it. And they ended up getting into an argument.
And she felt a rush of anger and ended up killing her.
But she should have had a clear murderous intent. I mean, she choked her out and then bludgeoned her to death.
She probably made her unconscious by accident. And from there, she couldn't go back. I somewhat understand that feeling.
Huh?
You can? That's pretty scary.
But Girl E was also killed by someone on the fourth day, or the game's last day. I might as well ask just in case. Who do you think killed Girl E? I see!
It should have been Guy F.
A scenario where Guy F murders Girl E out of a burning, hellfire desire to avenge his murdered sister.
Guy F is...
What?
It's just a story in a video game, isn't it? That's all you can say. If that game is telling the truth, it'd be a huge problem for you.
Hey, clear this up for me. Those of you who appeared as characters in the game, do you remember this incident?
That is... I'm terribly sorry, but...
They don't remember! That's obvious! Because their school memories were, like, totally stolen!
Even if I don't remember, I already know! It's obvious that guy is the killer! No one would kill a nice person like Mahiru besides a piece of shit menace to society like Fuyuhiko! Girl E and Mahiru were killed by that guy!
You sure do talk a lot of shit. Well, I'm used to it by now.
But does Mahiru's murder have anything to do with that game? Perhaps the two are unrelated.
No, the game and Mahiru's death are probably related. In actuality, there's an important shared point with Girl. The pictures. What is it, this? I'm tapped out, bro. I'm tapped out. That pissed me off too freaking bad, dog. That pissed me off too bad. I'm so tapped out right now, man. It's the metal bat. It's gotta be the metal bat. See, the thing is this, though. A blow to the head, that's a shared point. The fact that she took pictures, that's a shared point. What else? I understand the freaking bat, too. That also was a shared point, but goodness.
I can prove it with this.
Dang. You can't have four correct-
The two events are unrelated. At the very least, the killer has definitely played the game.
You can't have four correct answers and expect me. You can't have four answers that are correct and expect me to just casually choose the one that you want immediately. You can't expect that.
As proof, Mahiru, who was killed in the beach house, and Girl E, who was killed in the game, were both killed by a blow to the head with a metal bat. There's no way we can ignore that connection.
Someone must have wanted to split her head open the exact same way they avenged the first victim. Hey, why don't you confess already? You're the one who killed Mahiru, right?
You better cut that out right now! There is no way a stupid game could be the motive!
You're dumb enough to believe that stupid game, and that's why you killed her as revenge!
If you keep making up your minds like that, we're just going to go around in circles. And it's true for you, Hiko may look suspicious. Don't you think that'd be too obvious?
Unfortunately, it's probably Hiyoko.
What? What
are you... I mean, there's a possibility that it's a trap set by the true killer.
Trap? What do you mean?
The true killer played that game, and most likely found out about the relationships between the characters. That person could be using that knowledge to try to set up for Yuhiko.
Unfortunately, that's probably the case.
Are you saying that a completely different killer murdered Mahiru? And use the game motive as their cover?
Isn't that what happened, Yoko?
Huh?
Don't you understand? I'm saying you might be the true killer.
What is this? Like, I can only laugh. What are you even saying, you nasty toilet clogging bitch?
Hyoko's cheering me up. Hyoko's cheering me up. She's so silly.
What are you saying, you four-eyed troll? Accusing me of killing Mahiru? You're so mean!
Why do you doubt Hyoko?
Do you know where Hyoko was today? She was at the beach house, the scene of the crime.
But I didn't go to the beach house!
That is cap!
Wait a minute. You should have been at the beach house, Hyoko.
Seriously, I told you I didn't!
But these footprints in the sand in front of the beach house, aren't they yours?
I don't have such ugly footprints. They're probably Mikan's based on how ugly they are.
Don't decide that based on ugliness!
They're not Yoko's footprints? That's strange. The footprint I collected from your room matches these footprints perfectly.
Collected? I never gave you permission to collect that, you nasty pedo!
Plus, the footprints left in the sand were facing away from the beach house. Which means, when the owner of these footprints went inside the beach house, they used a different
entrance. Are you talking about the door facing the road that Makuru's body was in?
Byaku, you need to stop staring at me like that. I am not food, bro. I am not a feeling person. You will not be able to... You're not going to get no nutrients from me, gang.
Are you saying when that person went inside the beach house, the body hadn't appeared yet?
The door was still accessible when they went in and wasn't when they left.
Something happened between those two events. Isn't that right, Yoko?
Oh, I remember now. I remember when I went to the beach house.
Oh my, such a switch up.
So you finally decided to confess.
Look at Akane looking like she thinking hard. You know, good and time, well, nothing going on in that brain.
I'm pretty sure you guys already know this, but going for walks in the morning is my daily routine.
I've never heard of that daily routine before.
And that's when I went to the beach house. I went there on my morning walk.
I see. If you went there during your morning walk, that doesn't have anything to do with the case at all.
I told y'all she ain't had nothing going on in her head.
Don't believe her so easily, dumbass. She's obviously lying.
Yeah.
Huh? It's a lie? People who call other people liars are usually liars themselves. If you say I'm lying, prove it. Can you even prove that I'm lying? There's no way a bunch of worthless idiots like you guys would be able to do that.
That, bro, that's just... Yeah, letter to Mahiru.
I did go to the beach house.
Okay.
But only during my morning walk. I didn't go any other time.
Then you didn't meet up with Mahiru at the beach house?
Obviously not!
Cap!
Saying I met up with her when I never even saw her?
Yeah, she's lying!
I did go to the beach house.
She's lying about never seeing Mahiru! That's valid! The truth bullet was valid!
During your morning walk, huh? Will you still claim that after you take a look at this letter?
I was going to tell you in person, but I couldn't find you, so I put this in your mailbox. As we discussed earlier, is it okay if we change the place and time? Want you to come to the beaches on the second island at 2:30 p.m. It seems there's someone who wants to interfere with our meeting. Let's keep it a secret. Until then, let's try not to see each other for a while. It'll be bad if they start acting suspicious of us for no reason. Hyoko Sionji.
It's the one Mahiru had, right?
I see. So Hyoko was able to arrange a meeting with Mahiru by exchanging letters with her.
What is that letter? I'm
snap! I remember now! I totally saw you!
Huh?
Me and Hajime met up at the diner around 3 p.m. to go to the beach. I saw you about 30 minutes later, so it should have been around 3:30 p.m.
See. So if she met Mahiru at 2:30 p.m., killed her, then ran away afterward, I think 3:30 p.m. is a reasonable time for you to have witnessed here.
You're wrong! You're totally wrong!
Now that you mention it, you also passed by the diner Fuyuhiko. So you should have seen Hyoko too, right?
No, I didn't. It's just a coincidence that I passed by the diner. I wasn't even paying attention to the beach house. I went straight back to my cottage after I saw you guys. I didn't see anyone during that time.
For some reason, that sounds suspicious too.
It's the truth. Deal with it.
Just leave him alone. It'd be a waste of time to question him any further. Anyway, that letter in Kazuichi's testimony says it all. You were meeting up with Mahiru at the beach house.
Seriously? I don't know! I didn't even write that letter!
I doubt she has good handwriting.
I'm telling the truth! I really, really don't know!
Is she really crying? Or is she faking it?
She's probably faking it.
We can assume she summoned Mahiru with the intention of killing her all along. That's why she wrote a letter to let her know where to meet.
This is going by too fast, bro. This is going by too fast. She's not the killer.
And then you went ahead to the beach house, hid yourself in a specific place, and waited for Mahiru. There's evidence for that, too.
Hyoko was hiding with probably that place.
Where Hyoko was hiding. Are you talking about the closet?
Yes, that's right. The gummy candy we found on the floor is the evidence. Hyoko, your favorite candy is gummies, correct?
What's a gummy? I've never eaten something like that before.
I have captured the true character of this mystery. Hyoko, who summoned Mahiru to the beach house, hid inside the closet like a familiar. When she saw her chance, she attacked her like an evil spirit and left the beach house like a swift wind.
But Hyoko miscalculated that Mahiru's body would be blocking the door at that time. Because of that, she was only able to leave from the beachside door and ended up leaving her footprints.
We have presented the proof! My four dark devas of destruction didn't even need to come out!
This was too easy. There's more to it than that. There's more to it. Hyoko's not the killer.
It's a trap! This is obviously someone's trap!
Who's someone? Whose trap is it?
It must be that one person. You know, the one with the mask, maybe?
The one with the mask?
There was a suspicious mask at the beach house, right? Whoever was wearing that could be the real killer.
How did you know that?
You're the one who wore that mask and killed Mahiru, right?
There's no way I'd wear such a childish mask. Is your brain fried or something?
That is right. It cannot be Hyoko. That mask belongs to Sparkling Justice.
Huh? Sparkling what now?
That mask says it all. Sparkling Justice is hiding on this island. Which means the legendary serial killer Sparkling Justice is the one who killed Mahiru.
Why, you? If you continue to say such foolish things, I shall tear you limb from limb.
Don't blame me, Sonia! It's just a difference between cultures. Culture shock, you know?
Oh, my lord.
Hyoko, why don't you just admit it already? You're being unreasonably stubborn!
It's all in your head! Oh, why can't you understand? I'm not the killer!
It's true Hyoko is suspicious, but there's something strange. Something doesn't make sense. I can't help but feel we're all being directed by someone.
I shall...
Don't tell me it's Pekko!
Kyoko is the sinner who killed Mahi!
I'm telling you, it's a trap!
There's no doubt. You went to the beach house, right?
And weren't you also hiding in the closet? So that's when you dropped the gummy.
You waited for your chance to kill Mahiru.
And afterward, you fled from the beach house.
At the time the door closing the road, I was blocked by the body. So you were forced to flee from the beachside entrance.
And that's how you left your footprints.
Looks like everyone doubts Hiyoko. Is that really okay? I'm not understanding. What am I supposed to shoot? Conclusion.
Weren't you also hiding? So that's when you dropped the gummy.
No, that's wrong.
How is that wrong? How is that wrong?
About that gummy, did Hiyoko really drop it?
Hajime, don't say nothing stupid like she couldn't have dropped it because the gummy bag wasn't open yet. Dog, that's stupid! She could have multiple gummy bags! That better not be it. That better not be what you say.
The only one childish enough to eat gummies is that midget over there.
You're a midget too, you know. You're the one who worries about never getting taller.
It's true Hiyoko likes to eat gummies, but she only eats a specific brand.
Okay.
The brand of gummies you eat only have strawberry, melon, grape, and orange flavors, right?
Huh? But what about the lemon flavor?
Look, hold on a second, because it's about to make me mad. It's really about to piss me off. A yellow gummy, right? A yellow gummy. A yellow gummy that does not tell us what flavor it is. Let's go to the gummy bag. We can see yellow gummies in there. Come on, bro. Maybe if we knew that gummy was a lemon flavor, we could have, boom, I would have bop, shot that first go, just like that. But nah, bro, nah.
The gummy at the crime scene is yellow, so it obviously looked like it was lemon flavor.
Shut up.
Huh? That gummy is yellow? And it's not mine! The ones I eat don't have any yellow gummy.
Maybe my eyes should be deceiving me, but that gummy looks pretty freaking yellow right there. Maybe that's my eyes deceiving me though. Maybe I'm colorblind. Maybe I don't know color, but all I know is that gummy looks yellow. She's wearing orange, and that is, it's like an orange is red. Looks like.
That's right. None of the gummy bags in her cottage had any yellow ones.
There was only one gummy bag, but pop off.
Then we can't assume Hiyoko is the one who dropped that yellow gummy.
See? Didn't I tell you? It's definitely a trap! Damn it! Who would set a trap like this? I'll get my revenge! I'm gonna bop you on the head with all my might!
Hold on, you little bitch! You think you're in the clear just because of a little gummy? Don't be stupid! I'm not done backing you into a corner yet! We're not done with Hiyoko yet. There's still a huge piece of evidence left.
You're talking about the footprints near the beach house, right?
It's true, that's an important piece of evidence. And we can thank Mahiru for it!
What does that mean?
Mahiru used her last ounce of strength and blocked the door to the road. Thanks to her, we have the evidence we need.
That's wrong. I left those footprints during my morning walk.
We're not done with Hiyoko. There's still a huge...
You're talking about the footprints.
It's true. That's an important... We can thank Mahiru.
What does that mean?
Mahiru used her last ounce of strength and...
No, that's cap.
No, that's wrong.
Mahiru didn't block the door. Her death was instant.
Instant death? According to my autopsy, yes, there's no doubt that Mahiru died instantly.
If you keep making shit up, I'll fucking kill you!
I'm sorry! Ryuhiko, you cannot do that. Only a coward threatens women.
I'm pretty sure her death was instant, too. I mean, her injury was only a single blow. That's why Mahiru isn't the one who blocked the door. Someone else used her body to block it.
Someone else?
The killer, of course. They're the one who blocked the door with Mahiru's body.
Stop looking at me. Peko, please, don't tell me it was you, Peko. You're the only person who could have escaped through that window, so please don't tell me it was you, Peko.
That's why there were bloody drag marks left on the floor.
But why did the killer block the door?
Just ask Kyoko. She's the killer, after all.
Seriously? That's not true!
Let's assume Kyoko is the killer. Wouldn't that mean she's also the one who dragged the body?
She's too weak to do that.
If she handled the body that bloody, I think her clothes or skin would have been stained with blood.
Peko.
But when I saw her, she was...
Peko, it's not looking good for you, Peko.
She was clean.
See? I told you I wasn't the killer! Yay! With this, my innocence has been proven!
I won't let you look down on me!
You just mad for nothing, dawg!
We haven't decided that yet.
Hey, Fuyuhiko. Why do you keep insisting that Hyoko is the killer?
Shut up! I'm telling you, she's the killer! That little bitch is definitely the killer!
Bro, are you the killer? What's your issue?
If Mahiru didn't block the door, then Hyoko did it. She killed Mahiru and blocked the door with her body. Hyoko is the only killer I can think of. I can't back down.
What the freak?
If Mahiru didn't
That was so out of nowhere.
Hyoko did it. She killed Mahiru and blocked the door with her. Hyoko is the only killer I can think of.
If Hyoko moved the body, then she should be covered in blood.
Exactly.
So what, dumbass? There's a shower room inside the beach house. After she moved the body, she just washed it off in the shower.
Oh, I see.
The fact that Hyoko was at the beach house. Kenbi, did you get all that, you bastard? So what, dumbass? There's a shower room inside the... After she moved the body, she just washed it off in the shower.
Nah, that's
Allow
cap.
Me to cut through those
Allow words. Me to cut through those words!
Now, washing it off in the shower is impossible, because the shower in the beach house was out of order.
Out of order?
I'm terribly sorry. I haven't had any time to actually repair it.
Then... Maybe she took her clothes off to move the body, and when she was done, she put them back on.
She doesn't know how to tie her own sash.
Are you saying I did something that perverted?
That should be impossible.
I see.
Listen to me, Fuyuhiko. Kyoko mentioned this before.
I can't help it. I can't tie my kimono sash by myself.
Which means, Hyoko can't change by herself. It's impossible for her to put on and take off her clothes.
What?
Oh yeah, she couldn't even tie her sash on her own. That's why she couldn't take a bath and smelled bad.
I didn't smell. It only smelled a little.
Oh, wasn't changing inside the beach house prohibited in the first place?
Yes, if you broke the rules, I'm pretty sure Monokuma wouldn't have kept quiet.
Damn right! I'm such a stickler for the rules that even Safari Park Rangers want nothing to do with me! If she didn't change her clothes, then what did Hyoko do with the blood that got on her?
Like I've been saying, the blood wasn't on me in the first place, because I never touched Mahiru's body!
Hey, if you think about it the other way around, does that mean whoever was covered in blood is suspicious? Because if so, I believe Akane was soaked with blood when we all met up to go to the beach.
Didn't I tell you that was because I got beat up by Coach Nekomaru?
I can attest to that. If I hadn't gotten that rough with her, she never would have backed out.
Doubting me of all people. You got some nerve.
Kill him! Kill him, Akane! Kill him!
Alright, I'll bend your body in half so you're stuck in a bowing position for the rest of your life.
That actually sounds pretty cool!
The hell it does!
Hey, more importantly, I'm okay now, right? It's okay that I'm not the killer?
Yeah, seems like it.
See? I already told you! There's no way I'd kill Mahiru! Cause Mahiru taught me how to wear a kimono, and she was very, very kind! There's no way I would kill a nice person like her! Why wouldn't you believe me earlier? You guys are stupid! Stupid, stupid, stupid!
Hyoko, please don't cry. Everything is fine now, right?
Shut the hell up, pig barf! I hope you get a hangnail and die!
I'm sorry for being pig barf!
More importantly, Fuyuhiko's behavior earlier was definitely strange. Getting so worked up and accusing Hyoko of being suspicious. Could it be? Does he actually have something else in his mind?
Hey, Hyoko. Now that our suspicions have been addressed, can you tell us the truth?
Huh?
Even though you're not the killer, you still went to the beach house,
yeah.
Right?
Like I said, it was a trap!
Yeah, I got that already, so... can you give us the details about that trap?
I would like to know too. It might lead to some kind of clue.
Fine. You want me to talk, huh? Earlier this morning, Mahiru was the one who came up to me. She asked if we could meet up later.
Huh? But didn't you say earlier?
She never talked to me at all. Man, what a surprise. I didn't expect you to ask me such an easy question.
Damn it! So that was a lie?
Cause I thought it'd be doubted if I admitted it. So I figured it was better not to say anything.
So, what was your answer to Mahiru's invitation?
I told her it was fine. I mean, I didn't have a reason to say no. Unlike everyone else here, Mahiru was someone I wasn't embarrassed to be seen with.
You always have to say something snide.
At the time, we were supposed to meet around 2 p.m., but... around noon, there was a letter inside my mailbox.
A letter?
Yeah, this one.
Seems there's someone who wants... tell you a part I couldn't find who I put it in your mailbox. About what we discussed earlier, is it okay? 2 p.m. Someone wants to interfere with our meeting. Let's keep it secret until then. Let's try not to see each other for a while. It would be bad if they started suspecting us for no reason. Mahiru Koizumi. I see.
I got his letter and went to the beach house at that time.
Doesn't it clearly contradict the other one? I see what happened here.
I can prove it with this. This letter. Doesn't it look like its contents are different from the letter Mahiru had?
But we just gotta change the time of play, come to the beach at 2:30.
Mahiru's letter said to meet at 2:30 p.m. But in Hyoko's letter...
there's a place, 2 o'clock.
Whoa! The meeting times are off!
It's also strange that both letters wanted to change their meeting spot to the beach house. It would be plausible if one of them said it, but for both letters to say the same thing?
Hyoko, since you wrote it, what do you think?
Like I said, I never wrote the letter. How many times do I have to tell you?
Tend to say the letter was forged by the killer, but which letter did the killer forge? Both.
I see. The killer must have forged both letters. The killer forged them so they could manipulate their actions. Yeah, that's how we should think about it.
That seems very likely. In fact, if you compare both letters... Confirmed! Just as I assumed, the handwriting is the same. The content of the letters matches, too.
Not this part. I was going to tell you in person, but I couldn't find you, so I put this in your mailbox. This part, it seems there's someone who wants to interfere with our meeting. On this part, let's keep it a secret. Until then, let's try not to see each other for a while.
The killer forged both of those letters!
In doing so, they were able to control Hyoko and Mahiru to do their bidding, like a netherworld puppeteer.
Right now, I'm thinking it was Pekka. But please let it be Fuyuhiko. I don't like, bro. I need him up. I want him up out of here. And I really do. I really like Pekka.
So they completely tricked me. And then Mahiru's killer. How mean. Give me back Mahiru.
Really? This is really terrible. I've offered to help so many times. But the killer this time didn't discuss their plan with me at all.
Shut up.
It's all my fault. I'm so ashamed of being unreliable.
Here we go again. Once we let our guard down, this happens. We can just lightly punch him to death later.
So based on what the letter said, you went to the beach house at 2 p.m., right, Hyoko?
What's most important is what happened afterward. What on earth happened there?
I fell asleep. Why'd you fall asleep?
It's not like I wanted to. I think I was forced to get a whiff of some kind of medicine or something.
Medicine?
That medicine, could it be? Did they get it from the drugstore? I thought that place seemed unsafe. They even have prescription medicines laying out in the open.
If you were aware of that from the start, you should have done something about it.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
You should be sorry, actually.
When I woke up, I was inside a small closet. And when I rushed out, I saw Mahiru's body.
And that's why you ran out of the beach house in such a panic.
I was scared. I was really, really scared. Really scared that I couldn't help, but...
The killer probably planned to frame Hyoko from the start. And for that reason, they summoned Hyoko before Mahiru, put her to sleep, and shoved her inside the closet.
So their reason for blocking the door with Mahiru's body was to make Hyoko leave her footprints as evidence.
Everything was done to frame Hyoko as the killer.
That's horrible! I didn't do anything wrong!
Okay, we can shut up!
Hyoko, please do not cry. We believe you.
Is it really okay to believe her so easily? She might be faking those tears, you know.
This'll never end if you keep being so suspicious.
Isn't that what a class trial is all about? The only way to survive is to be suspicious. This is where we go to thoroughly doubt each other. So if you believe in each other so easily, then there's definitely something wrong with you.
Are you the killer, bro? Please tell me he's the killer, man, so we can get him up out of here. Because if he's not the killer, then it's definitely Pekka.
You're wrong, Fuyuhiko. We aren't supposed to doubt each other here. We're supposed to work together. The class trial is where we cooperate with each other, work hard, and aim for victory. The killer and everyone else. Two hopes attempting to grasp the one true hope. Two hopes clashing with each other is poetry in motion. That is what a class trial should be.
Seriously, which side are you on?
I'm on the side of the absolute hope that can overcome any despair. And I believe that absolute hope exists at the point where two hopes clash.
Your stance is neither white nor black, but gray. And you do not yearn for your life, or even for victory.
Jeez, I wish he'd just side with the enemy already so I can believe what he's saying!
Let's stop. Believing every little thing Nagito says is a waste of time.
Yeah, we need to figure out who Mahiru's killer is.
There should be a new clue contained in what Hyoko has told us. So, let us believe Hyoko's words and discuss it once again with everyone.
Yep, yep! The debate proceeds when you assume you can believe each other. Good job! That's the right way! That's the splendid power of teamwork! Hey, what do you think of that, Monokuma? I'm not gonna let you have the outcome you want.
Bro, hit her. That boy sleep.
Whoa. He's sleeping.
Dumbasses. You bastards don't know anything. If you're stupid enough to trust each other, the only thing waiting for you is the bitter truth.
The bitter truth. That may be true, but even so, we can't just stand around here all day. Even if what lies ahead is a cruel ending, the only thing we can do is move forward. Because unless we reveal who among us is Mayuri's true killer, there's no way we'll survive. Class trial suspended.
Well now.
Well then, the class trial has reached its good climax. I would like to present the answer right here, right now. Are you gonna spoil who the killer is? If I reveal the answer before everyone's ready, they'll all be shocked. They'll all feel despair. You can't, that's seriously a big no-no. Well, spoiling it right now is innovative, don't you think? The club president and I are powerless against innovation. Who's the club president? Without further ado, the answer is... You can't, everyone close your eyes and ears.
You say Nanu in German when you're surprised.
What are you on about? I'm thinking it's Pekko. But please, please tell me it's not Pekko.
My heart is to think that the person who killed the wonderful Mahiru Kwesumi is in this room. Impossible! Impossible! That's so impossible! There's no way I can believe that. Oh, I can't do anything.
Well, now that we've decided to believe Hyoko, now what?
If the killer was luring Hyoko into a trap, then something that was used there might be a clue.
Do you mean the letter?
No, it was probably the gummy.
Huh? Candy can be a clue?
What you staring at, bro? Keep your eyes to yourself.
Hey, when you woke up, was the gummy already there?
Now that you mention it, I feel like it wasn't.
Just as I thought.
Just as you thought?
If the killer planted evidence while Hyoko was there, she would have thrown it away if she found it.
Which means the gummy was placed inside the closet after Hyoko fled from the beach house?
The killer returned to the scene of the crime after I left?
They wouldn't have to do something that troublesome as long as they hid somewhere within the beach house.
That's impossible! There's nowhere to hide! I even glanced inside the shower room as I was running away, but there was nobody there!
Then, does that mean the killer came back?
I wonder. At any rate, the solution to that problem is connected to what really happened. That's what I think.
Pekko. I want to play a new game, is that what you're thinking? Perfect product for you, dive into your own brain, logically discern, logic dive. Control the version of yourself created from engine design, reach a goal, move sideways, accelerate, brake, jump, various obstacles. When did the killer arrive and depart from the beach house? Think. If I just focus and think about it, I'm sure I'll be able to find the answer. Alright, I'm gonna do it. What the freak? This is so stupid. Alright, that's a jump. That's brakes, and this is accelerate. I've always been pretty good at these type of games. I used to play a lot of Sonic, so I actually should be good with I should be good on this. When did the killer arrive at the beach house? It was after Hyoko arrived, right? Alright, I was wrong! Yeah, the killer must have got there before Hyoko. I'll give them that. Oh, crap. What? I literally didn't land on it. I just, bro, they tripping. What? Bro, these hitboxes are crazy. These hitboxes are absolutely terrible. Okay, when did the killer leave the beach house? Before Hyoko left. They left before Hyoko. I mean, I don't believe that, but okay. Yeah, because they were definitely in the beach house, even though she looked everywhere and didn't see them. They were definitely still in the beach house. It's not like they could have left and came back. Yeah, that's completely impossible. Please kill yourself. Where was the killer hiding while Hyoko was unconscious? I didn't even get a chance to answer the question, you know? Didn't even get a chance to answer the question. Didn't get a chance to answer the question. I guess the beach house.
It's all coming together.
Do you think the killer might have been hiding?
You spent all that time thinking just to say something so pointless. Disappointing.
But of course, because this is what the game wants it to be. That's what it's gonna be. Bro was hiding somewhere. But oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Bro was hiding somewhere in the beach house. Even though Hyoko confirmed that the killer was not hiding somewhere in the beach house. But yeah, that's what happened, bro. That's what happened. They're gonna find some way to make that the case.
Didn't I just say there was nowhere to hide? Do I have to explain it in another language so you can understand?
They're gonna find some way to make that the case, and it's gonna turn out to be true. Even if it's stupid.
A lot more forceful once she stopped being a suspect.
No, it should have been a place for them to hide. A place you didn't look real.
What are you saying? Stop being annoying, or I'm gonna make a Kami bop you on the head and shut you up for good.
Really don't want that to happen to me. I need to answer by any means. Dog, where? I don't know! She said she... The closet. Was bro somehow...
The killer was probably hiding in the closet.
The closet? That's where I was locked up!
I see where he's going with it, and it can make sense, but oh my goodness, bro. That's literally a logic dive. That's literally a logic dive. Bro dove off the highest logic cliff and did the longest logic dive and just came to something that just sounds like total bullcrap. But it's Danganronpa, so that's going to be the case. It's going to be true. That's going to be what happened.
After you woke up, you said you rushed out of there, right? And you probably didn't look inside the closet very carefully.
But could two people even hide in such a small place? And without Hyoko knowing?
That's why the killer made sure to arrange a hiding place.
I know where it is. It's right here.
Here!
What about the surfboard case in the closet? I'm pretty sure they could have hidden in there.
Huh? Inside the surfboard case?
But the shelf it was on. It was pretty messy, don't you think? Two surfboards were stacked on the top shelf. And there were surfboards that weren't even in a case. The killer probably did that on purpose to secure a hiding place. Because we haven't been on this island that long, so the closet shouldn't have been that messy, I think.
Then, the killer was close to me during that time?
Yeah. They were quietly holding their breath and hiding very close to you.
It's kind of like, in for a penny, in for a pound, so to speak.
Don't you mean, it's always darkest under the lighthouse?
I
shouldn't say things I don't understand, like, so to speak.
Anyway, the killer hid silently, and after making sure Hyoko left, they finally left the surfboard case.
I agree with that as well.
Seriously, nobody asked what you think.
Stop staring, bro!
There's no way the killer would leave Hyoko by herself if they were trying to frame her. If Hyoko was left alone and ruined the evidence the killer had planted, it would have messed up their plan. Instead, it makes more sense to think that the killer was hiding in the beach house, watching Hyoko.
Saying whatever you want, even if you didn't ask. All right, if you don't want to friggin' get punched, just stand still and let me punch ya! Oh, you shut up. Then, grit your teeth.
Sorry, Akane. It's not like that. Hey, Monokuma. Can I ask you about something that seems strange to me?
I believe Prince Shotoku was from the future.
Huh?
A man from the future is always directing the flow of history.
What?
I'll listen to your story about men from the future some other time. As I recall, the body discovery announcement is made when three or more people discover a body, right?
That means the killer had already seen it.
Is the killer also included among those three or more people?
Yeah, that's true, but, well, something like that is basically what it's supposed to be.
You don't sound very articulate.
Jeez! Pretty annoying for noticing something like that. I know it sounds like an excuse, but the body discovery announcement isn't supposed to be used for deduction. It's intended to create a fair trial. It's supposed to let everyone know a body has been found.
So you're saying it's unfortunate that I used it for deduction? I understand your excuse, but depending on who actually found the body, it's possible that your three or more people rule could be deadly.
Well, as long as I keep things ambiguous, I can respond to situations with some flexibility.
Flexibility, huh? So what about this time? Is it three people including the killer or not?
Jeez, fine, fine! You want me to say it? It doesn't include the killer this time, okay? All done.
Okay.
Which means three people other than the killer discovered Mahiru's body.
Me? Well, no, not me. It was Hyoko, the other guy. But who discovered it before them?
What's wrong with that?
Nothing. I just thought it was somewhat strange. More importantly, let's get back to our original topic.
You're the one who went on a tangent.
Who discovered the body before those two then?
We were just saying the killer was hiding in the surfboard case, right?
And after Hyoko ran away, the killer got to enjoy the simple life of destroying evidence.
However, before we proceed any further, there's something we have to make clear. The killer blocked the roadside door with Mahiru's body before Hyoko ran away. But what about the blood?
Now that you mention it, that mystery hasn't been solved yet.
It's going to be all right. If you guys have come this far, I'm sure you can discover that answer too. Now, let's start the argument, shall we?
Final feature in non-stop debates. Oh, thank God it's a final one. Truth flashback. Oh, that's stupid crap, bro.
What did the killer do with the blood on their body?
Maybe they simply washed it off.
They couldn't use the shower, right? So washing it off would have been impossible.
They didn't have to use the shower.
Oh, what about the wetsuits in the closet? Maybe they wore one when they moved the body.
If they used something other than the shower,
what did they do with the bloody wetsuit?
They cut it up and whoosh!
As someone who flushes their shit every morning, I can declare it would definitely clog the toilet!
Maybe it's the other way around? Perhaps someone other than the killer moved the body? Maybe they were able to wash it off. Use something other than the shower.
What did they do with the bloody wetsuit?
They cut it up and...
As someone who flushed, it would definitely clog.
Maybe it's together. Perhaps someone other... Maybe they were able to wash it off.
What did the killer do with the blood?
Maybe they simply washed it up.
They couldn't use the shower.
So washing it off would have been impossible.
No, that's wrong.
I sniped it.
They just needed to wash off the blood. They didn't necessarily have to use the shower.
Pecco! Why?
They could have just as easily used something else.
Something other than the shower. Like what?
Damn it!
Oh, that's true. It's not Pecco. Oh, thank God it isn't Pecco. The drink's in the fridge.
See. Drinks inside the refrigerator. Couldn't the killer have used those to wash off the blood?
I've seen through it.
Pecco! Why are you attacking me?
In theory, that's impossible.
Why?
Try to remember the refrigerator carefully, and then you will understand that there's no possible way the drinks in the refrigerator were used.
You're gonna be trash can.
It's true there were drinks in the beach house for however, trapped one bottle wouldn't be enough to wash off the blood.
I can't back down.
I don't understand.
It's true there were drinks in the beach house for however, one bottle wouldn't be enough to wash off the blood.
I can't back down.
Goodness! How far I got?
You can't assume they used just one drink. They could have used a bunch of them to wash it off.
Didn't I say it was impossible? There were no water bottles. There were only flavored drinks. If you use those to wash the blood won't come off in your body, it will leave an aromatic smell. Especially if you use the water that alone would break the suspicion.
Alright, there's no water bottles. That's what we got to attack it with.
There were no water bottles in the
CAP!
Allow me to cut through those words!
Oh, there were water bottles inside the refrigerator.
How many times do I have to tell you? There were no water bottles in there whatsoever.
That was after the incident, right? But before the incident, there were water bottles in the fridge.
Pecco's the killer.
And the killer took all of those water bottles and used them to wash the blood off their body.
So you're saying the water bottles were gone? Because they were all used? That's a logical fallacy.
It's not a fallacy. There should have been evidence inside the trash can. Evidence like a lot of thrown away plastic water bottles. Isn't that right, Chiaki?
Oh, you're right. These bottles look like they may have been filled with water.
Well, now that you mention it... When I went to the beach house a few days ago, I feel like I drank one of those plastic water bottles.
Huh? You should have said so sooner. Then, the plastic water bottles were used in place of a shower.
Dousing your body with lots of water bottles is such a simple and easy to understand explanation.
Hold on a sec. Now that I think about it, they soaked their entire body with a bunch of plastic water bottles. If they did that, that person would be...
It seems you've realized who the killer is.
Yeah, man.
See? Just as I thought.
Hold on. You know who the killer is?
Is that true?
Let me ask. Who might that be?
The killer used plastic water bottles to wash off the blood that splattered onto them. The killer, Mahiru's killer, must be that person.
You're the only one!
Why did it have to be you?
Pecco, is it you?
Hey, what are you being quiet for? They're accusing you of being the killer!
Then I should ask you this.
Why do you believe I'm the killer?
I remember when we were all meeting up to go to the beach. Your appearance when you came to the diner.
Hajime Kazuichi, why are you two here? Aren't you breathing pretty heavily? You did a little swimming.
If the killer really did wash the blood off with water bottles, they'd have to drench their entire body. But there were no towels in the beach house, and it would have taken a while for the water to fully air dry. So you said you went swimming so you'd have a cover story.
Don't just stay silent. Say something. Hold on, you bastard.
What is your issue?
You saw her at the diner. You never saw her near the beach house, right? So maybe she really was swimming.
No one even saw her swimming.
What is your issue?
No. I saw her.
Huh?
After I ran into you bastards at the diner, I crossed paths with her on my way home.
He's lying, bro. Look, I know what this is. Because Pekko killed Mahiru, who killed his sister, in the school time, he's covering for her.
So there's no doubt. She would have arrived at the diner from the opposite direction of the beach house.
Hold on. That's strange. Didn't you just say this earlier?
I went straight back to the hotel after I saw you guys. I didn't see anyone during that time.
You told me you didn't see anyone. Don't try to tell me you forgot about that.
Not so fast. It's too soon to decide she's a killer. We haven't established how the killer was able to leave the beach house.
Now that you mention it, you're right.
The roadside door was blocked. And if it's impossible to leave from the beachside without leaving footprints, then how the fuck did the killer escape?
Why are you all fired up, Fuyuhiko? You're not the suspect. Pekko is.
Who cares about that? Answer me! If you have an explanation, then show me what you got!
We might have an answer.
Huh?
Do you really? This mystery seems unsolvable.
Well, if Pekko is the killer, then I might just have an answer to that mystery.
I see. Then let's hear this alleged method of escaping the beach house.
First, let's establish how the killer escaped.
Killer's escape rope? I think I know what that is.
I see!
If the roadside and beachside doors aren't an option, the only other thing I can think of is... Well, nothing really. Except that small window in the shower room.
Don't you know how high that window is? There's no way Pekko could have reached it.
But what if, for instance, she got help from someone?
She might have reached it by riding someone's shoulders, but then that person would have been left behind.
Is it possible an object was used? A rope, for instance?
And what happened to the rope after they used it? And don't say something stupid like they threw it outside.
Of course not. That would violate the school trip rule.
Littering is prohibited. Even if it might be evidence, rules are still rules.
The thing is, Pekko could have used her sword and then kept it with her because it's her sword. Or because she's a talented warrior, she could have just made the jump.
You see, there's no way they'd be able to escape from that window.
No, they just have to use an object.
Chiaki, don't fall asleep on us. We just said they couldn't use an object.
You did? I thought you were saying they couldn't dispose of an object. I see. You don't have to throw it away if you can just hide it somewhere on your body.
Huh? Pekko was wearing a swimsuit, remember? Where would she even hide an object? And if you say she hid it in her special place, I'll stab you in yours!
No! Please don't be violent!
When the killer used an object to escape out the window, they wouldn't have had to get rid of it. I can think of it, the killer must have hid it somewhere, if that's the case. Hangman's Gambit. What is that? I didn't mean to do that. Oh, bamboo! Oh my lord. There we go. Bamboo sword.
Echo, you carry that bamboo sword on your back at all times, right? If I recall correctly, you had it then too. Despite the fact that you had a swimsuit on, you were still wearing your bamboo sword.
Are you saying she used that bamboo sword to escape through the window?
Yeah. Echo used that bamboo sword as a step stool and escaped out the window.
Sword as a step stool? You see? I knew it! I knew it was a ninja! Didn't I tell you? A ninja could have climbed that easily! Ninjas know a climbing trick where they lean their sword against a wall and use the handguard as a step stool.
Whoa! Just like a Japanese ninja!
Miss Sonia, ninjas only exist in Japan.
Well, it is a bamboo sword, but I'm sure a slender girl like Peko could easily use it to climb.
Well, Peko, do you have anything to say?
Panic talk action. Fever time and nigga time. From this point on. Oh, okay, it's just a focus crap. Oh! Dang it! Hold on, I got you. Hold on a second, you bastard. You saying she used the sword as a bamboo? Sword as a step stool and went out the freaking window? What about the sword? Would have been left in the shower room and she wouldn't have been able to recover it. Who you, Hiko? Why do you care?
Shut up! Just shut the fuck up and answer me! If you have an answer, then fucking give it to me! If she used the bamboo sword as a step stool, it would have been left behind!
Why are you, bro?
Got proof, you bastard? That's obviously impossible. Shut up! Don't fuck with me. Got proof, you bastard? Shut up, you bastard!
I hate the timing for this one, bro.
If she used the bamboo sword as a step stool,
bamboo sword bag.
If she used her bamboo sword as a step stool, she could have recovered it with her sword bag. When she leaned her sword against the wall to use as a step stool, she tied her sword bag to it. And after she climbed up to the window, as long as she hauled the bag up toward her, she would have been able to recover her bamboo sword.
I see. Not just the bamboo sword, but even the sword bag, too. Hakane said she's like a ninja, but it's nothing as silly as that. Simply put, only Peko could have performed this feat. An escape plan befitting of the ultimate swordswoman. Even so, how disappointing. If you'd only let me work with you, it would have been an even greater plan. No! Oh, you just back off!
Papa, is it true?
Hold on! You're just making assumptions! You don't have any proof. I won't accept this unless there's proof! Got it, you bastard!
Bro, hop off.
It's fine.
Huh?
I said it's fine. Saying anything more would just be an exercise in futility.
She admitted it just now, right? She admitted she's Mayuru's killer, right? But is this right? Even though Fuyuhiko was the one arguing against us, Peko just admitted it so freely.
Among flowers, the cherry blossom. Among men, the samurai. I commend your decisiveness, at least.
Very well. If you admit it, this ends now. Let's cast our votes.
Agreed. Hurry up and vote.
Hold on. Let me confirm one thing first.
Can it wait until after the voting?
This is important, and it relates to the voting. It's about Peko's motive.
My motive?
Yeah, why did you do it?
In the end, you had no connection to the events depicted in Twilight Syndrome murder case, right?
That's the big reason why I didn't want to think it was Peko. Because not only do I like Peko, but it just really makes no sense. Like, of course, the actual case and like how it happened, it all kind of adds up to Peko. But besides all of that, the actual reasoning behind it and why and all of that, it's just stupid. It doesn't make sense.
Then, why did you kill Mahiru?
So it's about that. Let's see. If I must answer that question, I must say it was for the sake of justice.
Huh?
Justice?
In order to protect the justice of this world.
Oh, Lord.
I do not sully my hands to satisfy personal grudges. There is only one reason I kill. For the sake of protecting justice.
What are you saying?
Justice is what makes humans human. It's a virtue that human beings should be proud of. Justice is the eternal sun and the enduring moon, the protective father and the smiling mother.
Hello! Earth to Peko!
If justice ever disappeared from this world, the world would immediately freeze and people's smiles would vanish. I will not allow that!
It's fine, just stop it!
Justice must always be there to guide us, to shine bright above our heads.
I'm telling you to stop it!
So I must fight. I must continue to fight to protect justice.
This is... could she be?
As the light of justice shines upon my mask, I expose the hearts of malevolent evil. Justice complete! The center of justice that is pierced by justice. The lead star of justice that shines in the night sky. That would be me. Sparkling justice!
Don't put the stupid emoticon!
Now then. Let's execute justice!
What?
What the fuck? Peko, what are you doing?
I am Sparkling Justice. In the name of Sparkling Shining Justice, I have come to deliver justice.
What's going on? What's this chill?
Peko finally snapped! Everyone, please be careful! Sparkling Justice is a serial killer who claims to be an ally of justice. Clad in her various hero masks, she is a serial killer who exclusively targets other criminals. She is supposed to be...
Ally of justice? So that's why you're wearing a mask! This mask is the dividing line. Just like various idols, the sun is revered because it lies just beyond your hands. Justice should also be the same.
I don't get it!
These emoticons are pissing me off.
This is becoming really crazy!
What? What the heck is this? Peko is the killer. Why is it turning out like this?
This is turning out to be a surprising turn of events! Hey! Now's not the time for you to be sleeping! Take a look! It's a killer!
This again?
Huh? Sleepwalking? So what's your answer to my previous question? Why did you kill Mahiru?
This world must always be bathed in the light of justice. I must not allow even one shadow.
Then why did you kill Monokuma?
Evil must be eliminated immediately. No matter what, I must not overlook evil.
Evil? Are you saying Mahiru is...
If you knew about that incident, then you must have played the game. Am I right?
And because of that, I was able to find the killer's accomplice hiding on this island like a sewer rat.
Then, the reason you killed Mahiru was...
To protect justice, of course. In order to protect justice, I have become its merciless sword. And... executed justice.
Holy crap! She's such a stereotypical psychopath!
She's so gross!
Echo, is this your true identity?
My true identity? I have already forgotten who I am. It just shows my determination. My determination to protect by throwing away what's most important. I'm willing to become anybody to shower this world with justice.
Oh, I can't stand this anymore. Let's just end this farce already.
End it. He's right. We need to end this already. Killer in the end, there's no mistake. It was Pekka all along.
Let's go over this incident one more time and then let's end this.
This case is a headache.
Began this morning when Mahiru spoke to Hyoko.
This case wasn't even a headache because it was difficult. It was just so... it's just absurd.
Mahiru most likely played Twilight Syndrome murder case, the video game provided to us as the motive. She probably wanted to discuss it with someone else who also appeared in the game as a character. Hyoko accepted Mahiru's invitation, and they promised to have a more detailed conversation about it later. However, someone else overheard their exchange. The killer. The killer eavesdropped on their conversation and used their promise to devise a specific murder plan. By preparing a specific item, they planned to manipulate the two's actions. That item was the letters. They sent fake letters to both Mahiru and Hyoko. The letter Mahiru received told her to come to the beach house at 2:30 p.m. And the letter Hyoko received told her to come to the beach house at exactly 2 p.m. By providing different times, the killer was able to lure them to the beach house separately. Hyoko totally trusted that letter, showed up at the beach house at 2 p.m., just like it said. And was drugged into unconsciousness by the killer lying in wait. After putting Hyoko to sleep, the killer immediately hid her inside the closet, so they could frame her as the killer later. At 2:30 p.m., Mahiru arrived at the beach house. She was completely unaware that she had been targeted for murder. Approaching her from behind, the killer struck the defenseless Mahiru with a specific weapon. The metal bat that was left at the scene of the crime. The bat was brought down onto the back of Mahiru's head, and with that, she took her last breath. According to Mikan's autopsy, Mahiru died instantly, so she probably never knew who killed her. With that, the killer achieved their goal of killing Mahiru and began to tamper with the crime scene. They dragged Mahiru's body so that it blocked the door leading to the road. Also, the mask found at the scene of the crime was something the killer personally left. I'm not really sure why. My guess is, it's something similar to a calling card. That's how the crime scene we discovered was created. However, by moving Mahiru's body, the killer got blood splatter on them. Plus, the shower room had no water because it was out of order, so they couldn't wash it off. But the killer expected something like that to happen. Instead of the shower, the killer used something else to wash the blood off their body. They used plastic water bottles that were inside the beach house refrigerator. We can assume they carried the bottles to the shower room before the sequence of events had happened. In place of showering, they washed the blood off their body with water bottles instead. However, they had no choice but to dispose of the empty bottles in the beach house's trash can. Littering is against the rules, and it would have taken too much time to throw them away somewhere else. After the killer washed off the blood, they hid in a specific spot inside the closet Hyoko was in. The killer hid inside the surfboard case that they had already emptied beforehand. After some time had passed, the sleeping drug used on Hyoko wore off and she woke up. I can imagine how badly Hyoko must have panicked when she came out of the closet. I mean, she made plans to see Mahiru, who lay dead right in front of her. From the shock and panic of being considered a murder suspect, Hyoko fled from the beach house. Because of that, she left footprints in the sand. Everything was a trap set by the killer to frame her. After Hyoko left, the killer finally came out of the surfboard case and placed a gummy that they brought with them to shift our suspicion toward Hyoko. Ironically, placing that gummy is what helped clear our suspicion toward Hyoko. Finally, the killer began preparing to escape from the beach house. They couldn't risk leaving their footprints in the sand, so they escaped the beach house using a different route. The small window in the shower room. However, that window is rather high up and can't be reached easily, which is why the killer used the bamboo sword they always carry with them. The killer took the bamboo sword out of its bag, tied the bag to the sword's handle, and used the sword as a step stool to reach the small window while holding the sword bag in their hand. As long as they're able to reach the window, all they had to do was pull the bag to retrieve the sword. And so the killer left the beach house and appeared before us as if nothing had happened. But their wet hair and swimsuit didn't dry right away. There also weren't any towels at the beach house. So when the killer met up with us, they said they had been swimming for a while as an excuse. So how about it? This is the truth behind the incident you caused. Isn't that right, Peko Peko Yama?
I see. And what of it?
She's like totally cool with it.
I haven't done anything to be ashamed of.
What are you saying? You killed Mahiru!
Wrong! I punished evil in the name of justice. That's no reason to condemn me.
Whatever. Let's hurry up and vote so we can freaking kill this weird, crazy bitch.
There's no way you can kill me. Justice can never be killed. You should all know that as well.
What are you saying?
To protect what's most important to you, you must be prepared to throw away something equally important. Understand?
I don't get it at all!
Monokuma, just execute her!
Then I shall be direct. Justice must carry on in order to keep justice. To keep me alive, you all must give up your lives.
Are you serious?
It's not serious. It's justice.
She's making me mad. She's making me mad.
By far, who will combat the evils of this world? Now, follow your hearts of justice that reside within you all, and save my life to protect justice. Hurry and carry on justice!
Give me a break! Who's gonna die for you?
If we let Pekko go, we're all gonna get killed!
For the sake of grand justice, a few sacrifices are unavoidable.
A few sacrifices? Yes!
Don't worry. The justice that you give your life to protect will never go to waste.
I can't stand her anymore! Let's vote already and execute her!
Get him, buddy.
However, before we do that...
Monokuma, the vote! Hurry up and let us vote already!
I'm awake!
Ah, he finally woke up!
I've heard your story! Well, I wasn't listening, but who cares? Now then, please pull the lever in front of you and cast your vote! Who will be chosen as the Blackened? Will you make the right choice or the dreadfully wrong one? Such heart-pounding excitement!
Please let us continue our discussion.
Continue our discussion? But isn't the voting over?
Yes, but I cannot help but feel strange. Something about this is definitely strange.
Huh?
Strange? What do you mean? There's no doubt that Pekko is the killer.
That is true, however...
As a serial killer enthusiast, you're wondering if Pekko is really sparkling justice, am I right?
Huh?
Hey, Miss Sonia isn't a serial killer enthusiast. She just has a little more passion about them than most.
Shut up.
That makes her an enthusiast.
Honestly, it felt strange to me too. I mean, there's a distinct difference between what we know about sparkling justice and Pekko, right?
Distinct difference?
You know, Sonia describes sparkling justice like this.
Justice complete! The center of justice that is pierced by justice! The lead star of justice that shines in the night sky! That would be me! Sparkling justice!
What the heck was that? That is sparkling justice catchphrase. An unknown serial killer has a catchphrase? I read it in a magazine in the library. There has only been one person, a journalist, who has interviewed Sparkling Justice. The article was written in their native language, so I tried translating it. I see, so that's what it was. I think I've got the difference between serial killer and Pekko. I don't know, nationality?
According to what Sonia said,
the article was written in their native language, so I tried to translate it.
If she had to translate it, that means it wasn't written in English, right?
Huh? Yes, the magazine I read was written in Spanish. So, Sparkling Justice's catchphrase was no doubt written in Spanish as well. Which means the journalist and Sparkling Justice are both...
from Spain?
What?
All this time I completely misunderstood. When I first heard about those serial killers, Genocide Jack and Sparkling Justice, I assumed they were from the same country. That isn't the case, if so...
Pekko, you're not Sparkling Justice. There's no way that's possible.
Or, you insist that you're Sparkling Justice. Can you try saying that catchphrase in Spanish?
Would you be able to do that?
It appears that the time has come for this mask to come off. However, that's perfectly fine. It's no longer necessary. And even if you find out now, it's too late for you all to do anything about it. My duty has already been finished. My duty as a tool has already been completed in full.
Huh? Looks like she's back to normal?
That mask has fulfilled its purpose, just as I have.
What do you mean? Fulfilled its purpose too late? What are you getting at?
Now that you've already cast your votes,
she's not the killer? What?
Hey, be clearer! We're asking you what your purpose was.
I have no purpose. I am just a mere tool.
Tool? What do you mean?
She called herself a tool, which means someone else used her then?
Of course. A tool cannot do anything on its own.
I see. I finally understand. Well, I did have a sneaking suspicion all along.
What do you mean?
I mean, besides Pekko and Yoko, someone else was also at the beach house.
Bro, who?
Someone else?
There is proof that establishes that fact. Try to remember it.
Yeah, the biodiscovery announcement.
I see. Are you talking about the biodiscovery announcement?
That's what I was trying to figure out. Like, who was it? Who was the first person to see the body?
Yep, that's right. I mean, didn't Monokuma say so earlier?
3 people, including the killer, or not? Fine, you want me to say it doesn't include the killer this time?
That announcement is made when at least 3 people discover a body. And in this particular case, the killer, Pekko, is not one of those 3. If that's the case, it would mean only Hyoko and Kazuichi discovered the body, but...
I see. That leaves us 1 person short.
So that means there was 1 more person in the beach house.
Plus, the fact that Monokuma tried to hide that truth from us by being flexible with his own rules. That's such a vital clue that it could alter the outcome of the trial. Like an accomplice, for example.
No, that's not it.
Huh? Am I wrong?
Yes. From your basic way of thinking about it, you are wrong. Didn't I tell you? I'm just a tool.
She's not the killer, then.
That means I'm just a simple tool to be used by that person.
That means Pekko doesn't count as the killer. She was simply a tool used to kill. So she's technically innocent.
Therefore, that person would have the strongest motive out of anybody else here, right?
So it's him.
The only one.
Bro, what is up with these plot twists?
I see. Now I finally see the connection. The connection between the motive and the incident.
But even if it's the motive, it's just a game, right? There's no reason to believe it's even true. Would you call a game like that a strong motive?
The events that occurred in this game should have occurred in real life. Overwhelming proof for that. That's the proof! Bro, that's... Are these pictures of it happening in real life not enough? I mean, this is what I meant.
I can prove it with this.
I clicked the wrong one. Okay, that's my bad.
I didn't think it was necessary to confirm it if it didn't have anything to do with Mahiru's murder, but there's no doubt that game is based on actual events. That much is clear if you saw the ending prize. The photos awarded for beating the game are not actual in-game screenshots.
The first photo that I selected, the first one I selected is the first piece of evidence he brings up. But it was wrong. All right, I see.
They're all actual photos with the surrounding scenery cropped out. You knew all along, Fuyuhiko, did you? You knew whether or not the first victim in the game was actually your little sister, right? Because whoever beat the game first received the ending prize.
Hey, what's that envelope? What's inside? Shut up. What makes you think I have you the right to question me?
It was the envelope, right? The person who received the ending prize. It was you, wasn't it?
If you were shown a photograph of your sister's dead body, you'd have no choice but to believe it. Even so, you wanted to deny the truth. That's why you sent those photos to Mahiru to confirm it.
Hey! Why are we talking about Fuyuhiko? Who cares? Because Peko is the killer, right?
But he voted.
That's why I told you. You're all too late. As I said before, I exist as nothing more than a tool.
Watch Monokuma be like, uh-oh, SpaghettiO! I think I'm gonna do the voting again.
I had no motive for killing Mahiru. No reason to kill. Not even the will to kill. I was simply used as a tool. As long as I am a tool, I cannot defy my orders.
Hey! What's going on? Can anyone give me a simpler explanation?
It means I'm not the killer. The true killer, who used me as their weapon to kill Mahiru Koizumi, was Fuyuhiko Kuzuryu.
What?
What the hell?
I see. That's what you were aiming for all along.
No. I have no aim. But my young master does. My young master planned this from the start.
Young master?
That is the truth of this case. I'm sure you realize it by now, but it's too late. You cannot undo the vote.
Bro.
That's a problem. If Peko's allegation holds up, that means our vote was incorrect.
Monokuma's about to pull up like, nah, we can do it again. Why not?
In that case, the person who gets to live is...
just... me?
That's nuts! No matter how you look at it,
how would Peko be a tool in the first place? Peko is a legitimate human being!
That's not for you to decide. It's for Monokuma. The votes have been cast. All we can do now is wait and see what Monokuma decides.
What the hell?
It is. I guess for now, let's take a quick recess. We'll be right back after this commercial break.
Although there were some twists and turns along the way, the one who killed Mahiru Koizumi is... Hey, hold on a second. Okay, I'll wait. So sorry, I'm just hesitating. There's no need to hesitate, no matter how you look at it, Peko's the killer. Why?
Hey.
Why? Well, that's obvious. You're not a tool, you're a freaking human being. If I'm human, then I'm not a tool. If that's what you're saying, you're wrong.
You just don't know.
You just don't know that there are people who only exist to be tools. People such as myself. Only exist to be tools.
Hey.
What does she mean for you, Hiko?
Yeah.
Peko and I grew up together. Are you two childhood friends then?
No.
It is completely different than that. Right after I was born and abandoned by my parents, the Kuzuryu clan took me in.
I'm nothing but a tool.
They gave me a reason to exist. I am to fulfill my duty as my young master's property.
What?
Property, you say? It means she's a hitman arranged by my clan to work directly under me.
My young master is attacked. I must defend him as his shield. If he intends to kill, I must be his sword. That is my only reason for living. Before I am human, I am my young master's tool, first and foremost. Until this body of mine can no longer move, I shall fulfill my duty until the very end.
That is...
But that is, you are wrong. You are not a tool, Pekka. Because if you are a tool, then what was all that time we spent together?
Nothing.
Dang. I was ordered by my young master to behave, just as I was ordered to interact with you all. Goodness. Our professional relationship doesn't exist on this island. We're just fellow high school students now. Right after we arrived on this island, that is what my young master ordered me to do.
You fiend.
That is why you're hiding your relationship, you mean?
No.
It's not as if that started the moment we arrived on this island. Before that, my young master has always told me to hide our relationship. My young master loathes relying on his household's power. He even hates me, the tool given to him by his household.
I am nothing but a tool.
No matter what I am told, I am nothing but a tool for killing. If my young master intends to kill, it is only natural for me to act as his tool. And the one who tried to kill Mahiru isn't you, it was Fuyuhiko.
Damn it.
It is what it is. When I thought I beat the game, I was suddenly given these photographs.
Damn it!
I don't understand. Why is my sister in these photographs?
Don't fuck with me!
And she's covered in blood? What does it mean? Why can't I remember? How come I don't even know if my sister's dead?
You
tried to confirm it with Mahiru, and that's why you wanted to talk to her.
So?
Yeah, I sent her the photos because I wanted to make sure she'd respond. But she never replied back to me. Not only that, she started avoiding me too.
But...
I'm pretty sure Mahiru was confused too. I mean, we all were. Before anyone played the game, we didn't even know this incident had happened. That's why, even if we were told we were connected to it, there's no way we could accept it. You know, when Myra spoke to Iluki, she mentioned something about this.
Aww.
Sorry, actually I have plans to go to the beach with everyone.
Oh my my!
Wait, huh? You're not gonna go, Myra? If you want to talk about it there, it'd be totally fine. It is pretty important, so you know. It'd be troubling to involve the others.
Huh?
You sound pretty serious. Serious or not, I can't really do anything about it on my own, so I wanted someone to think about it with me.
But...
If I need to make amends, I would, but I don't even know how.
Are you serious?
That definitely sounds serious. I can cancel my beach plans for you. No, it's fine. It's important that everyone gets along anyway. Just tell them I'm not feeling well. Plus, it doesn't have to be today. There's always tomorrow. She wanted to discuss how to make amends, but Hyoko was the only one who accepted her invitation. I should have gone too.
But
it's rather convenient for you, wasn't it, Fuyuhiko? You can make use of their plan to meet each other alone. You could easily lure Mairu into a trap, right?
Hey.
By calling both of them to the beach house, you were able to pin the blame on Hyoko.
What the?
Seriously, what the heck? An eye for an eye, that's the world I live in. My little sister was murdered. If the reason that happened was because of some person here, I have no choice but to kill that person on my sister's behalf, right?
And so
my young master thought of a plan and executed it. I wanted to use a bat as a murder weapon because in the game, that's what was used to kill Girl E. For revenge, clubbing the person to death the same way my sister was killed just seemed to make sense. Even if it ruined my disguise, it was the only thing I could do to avenge my sister.
That is...
So that is why you killed Mahiru with the bat.
Yeah.
But still, I believed her up until the very last minute, that the game was just a work of fiction. But even so, that...
Hey,
if that game is actually real, are you the one who killed Girl E?
Why, you...
Hey, I don't want to hear about that.
The
fact that your sister was killed is terrible. It's unfortunate, but...
Why?
You shouldn't have killed that girl.
Shut the hell up!
Who cares about that? Just answer me. What do you know about that game?
What are you saying?
You had no right to do that. Nobody has the right to judge others for their crimes. Revenge is just wrong. Jeez. Want me to be honest? This whole time I was acting like a coward. Even after I called over my hero, I was still trying to find an excuse not to go through with the plan. But after she said that to me, that all went out the window. I got really pissed and grabbed the metal bat I hid under the bench. But at that moment, Young Master called for me and made me kill my hero.
Huh?
Huh?
Young Master, I am finished.
What?
You're saying you killed Myru just because you were ordered to? A tool is not defined by its will, but by its actions. I don't get this at all!
Of course!
Well, of course you don't! Because humans are completely different from one another. Everyone's birthplace and upbringing is different. It's obviously impossible for them to understand each other. So everyone just pretends to understand and pretends to be understood.
Be quiet.
Hey, you're too annoying. Can you be quiet?
Yes, indeed.
Okie dokie, I'll be quiet. Afterwards, this is my young master plan. I proceeded to tamper with the scene of the crime. However, I also considered the possibility of being found out. So in order to get you guys to make the wrong choice, I decided to make use of that serial killer story.
It cannot be.
You insisted that you were sparkling justice in order to make us hasten our votes. So we fell for it. We fell for a trick all along. That's right. You guys have made the wrong decision. You voted for me, a mere tool, as the killer, unaware that my young master was a true killer.
That's obviously wrong.
Hey, don't act like our vote has been decided yet. I lost. No, it should be decided already. Isn't that right, Monaco?
This is troubling.
I'll admit, all this talk about Pekko being a tool sounds pretty persuasive. When you approach from various angles, it makes sense that Fuyuhiko is actually the true killer. Hey, I'm telling you to hold on.
I see.
I see. So for Pekko, Fuyuhiko himself is your true hope then. On his behalf, you killed Mahiru, and now you're trying to sacrifice us so you can protect him.
Great.
You would only go that far because he's your one and only hope.
Wrong.
I have no hope. I am just a tool. Well, even if we ask her, she'll probably just play dumb anyway.
Now then.
So I'm going to ask someone else. Hey, Fuyuhiko, what do you think?
Huh?
About what?
Hey.
Is Pekko just a tool to you? Using that tool, surviving by chance? Surviving by sacrificing Pekko and the rest of us? Is that your hope?
What?
Hold on.
Hold on. What's the use of asking something like that?
What?
Huh, you seem distressed. A mere tool doesn't panic like that, right?
Jeez.
Pekko, be honest. Are you trying to protect Fuyuhiko of your own will?
Hey.
Fuyuhiko, can you tell me the truth? The fact that she killed on your behalf, the fact that she lied to about acting like the true killer, are those things you order her to do? Is that the truth?
Huh?
Fuyuhiko.
Yeah.
I know you hate our guts, but if you listen to Pekko, we're all gonna die. You just have to tell the truth. I was only following your orders. You just have to tell them that. Fuyuhiko, you mentioned this before, but in this kind of situation, interacting with others will just shorten your lifespan. Those idiots, Byakuya and Terra, are proof of that. Plus, it'd be frustrating to get held back by affection when it's my time to kill. You're still saying that. Of course, I'll sacrifice the lives of everyone here if it guarantees my survival. You don't really feel that way, right? You're not that kind of person. Because if you were, you wouldn't be hesitating like you are now, right?
Young Master!
There's no need to hesitate, Young Master. Please, tell them the truth. Young Master, you were the one who ordered me. I just did as I was told because I am a tool. Fuyuhiko, this could be considered your ultimate choice. Regardless, either way, you'll still lose Pekko, but
hey,
if you insist you're the killer, just as she said, you can sacrifice us and survive alone. Or would you rather reject Pekko and fight alongside us against despair? Which will be your hope? Let's hear what you have to say.
Damn it!
Young Master, I am finished.
You? What the hell did you do? You already know, right? What's going to happen after you kill someone?
I did it because I know. There is no way I can let that happen to you.
Hey, Pekka. Do you remember what I told you when we first arrived on this island? Our professional relationship doesn't exist on this island. We're just fellow high school students now. You need to run. Got it? Just let me take the fall so you can get away.
Young master, that is impossible.
Shut up! I'm ordering you not to worry about me!
There is no way I cannot worry about you. I am my young master's tool. A tool to protect my young master. Without an owner, the tool serves no purpose.
God damn it, we are done with that crap! Why won't you listen to what I'm saying?
Regardless, I will not flee. Besides, I'm fairly certain they'll discover the truth soon enough.
Then why did you...
I have a plan.
Huh? A plan?
Please do not worry. I promise I will keep my young master alive and return him safely home.
You idiot. What do you intend to do?
I intend to fulfill my duty as your tool. Now please, go! Hyoko will be waking up soon. After you leave, I must block the door to the road with Mahiru's body. Hurry!
Damn it. You better run away. Got it? Just forget about me! Forget about the Kuzuryu clan! You better escape!
So how about it, Fuyuhiko? Please, tell us the truth.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, Pekka. I guess I couldn't go through with it after all.
Young master!
I'm a disgrace.
Because if that's actually what I have to do to survive, I just feel ashamed of myself. It'd mean I can't live without depending on something. I just feel disgusted with myself.
Pekka.
And if I admit that, it means you really are just a tool to me. How many times did I tell you? I don't want a tool given to me by the Kuzuryu clan.
Young master.
Uh-oh.
Oh my! So this is how it turned out.
Too bad.
And here I thought it'd be more brutal and heartless. Man, how disappointing. Which means everything that happened thanks to her meddlesome actions.
Why you?
There's no way a human that meddlesome could ever be considered a tool.
Hey.
Monokuma, you knew all along, didn't you? You knew what Pekka and Fuyuhiko discussed.
Jeez.
Well, it's obvious now. I mean, that's why you have surveillance cameras. You were just having fun, huh? Man, even if it was an act of desperation, Pekka's claim was surprisingly interesting. You're actually the first to try and influence the outcome of the trial like that. But too bad, you're definitely the killer. Pekka, the tool with the heart is the killer.
Sorry.
Pekka, I'm sorry I couldn't fulfill your request. Even though you did all that to provide me with a chance to survive. But I had a feeling it would turn out like this.
Huh?
Young master.
Young master, you have a kind heart despite being a Yakuza. That's why you question your position and constantly worry about it. For you to sacrifice someone else just to escape by yourself, I believed you wouldn't accept that so easily. We've been together ever since we were children. Even a tool would understand that.
What?
Then why?
Even so.
Even so, I wanted you to escape. I wanted to protect you.
Pekka.
I am terribly sorry.
I will not be able to serve by your side until the very end, young master.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. And I'm sorry for what I've done to you all, too. It may be a selfish request, but please forgive my young master.
And please, do not cause a senseless killing such as this ever again.
Of course. That will do, Monokuma. Why don't you start it already?
I will never feel despair.
As long as I am a tool, I am fully prepared to die.
So cool!
But will you maintain that composure to the very end? People who act as proud as you always shed tears of despair in the end.
Celeste didn't.
Uh-uh. Nah, cause Celeste was terrified. But she stayed strong. Now then, let's begin.
Young master for you, Hiko.
Please permit me to make one final selfish request.
So?
Didn't I tell you not to call me young master?
I want you to remember.
The tour Peko Peko Yama who used to stand beside you. I would like it if you remembered that. That's it. How many times do you have to keep... I don't need any tools. You did say that.
Then let's begin. The punishment time is brimming with despair.
Jeez.
Why don't you get it yet?
Thrills, chills, kills!
This time for the ultimate swordswoman, Peko Peko Yama.
Why?
You stayed by my side all this time. Why don't you get it?
Now then, I prepared a very special punishment.
I never needed a sword or a shield.
I never needed a tool. So, you didn't need to become a tool.
Let's give it everything we've got!
You just needed to be yourself. I never wanted a tool. I just wanted you. Only you.
Young master?
Why? Why couldn't you understand? We've always been together ever since we were kids!
Let's go! It's punishment time!
Please, Peko. Don't go! I need you! Don't leave me!
Young master?
Oh, man.
Young master?
No! Even Fuyuhiko? This is bad. This shouldn't be allowed. People dying so easily, falling like dominoes. You bastard, what is this? They both? This can't be. This is a lie, right? Peko! Fuyuhiko!
Such a waste.
For heaven's sake, this is just the worst. Jeez, what a waste. This conclusion, what a waste. This is why she should have just discussed it with me.
Damn it.
It was supposed to be a clash between two hopes, but it was crushed into something so unpalatable.
Oh.
You're still talking about that.
You.
Hell's wrong with you? Aren't you pissed that two of your friends got killed?
Such despair.
I am pissed. I even feel sad and hopeless. But still.
Isn't that right?
It's gonna be alright. This despair is worthless. Even this despair is just a ladder to a bright, shining future that awaits us. The higher the ladder, the brighter we can shine. That is the unmistakable truth.
Calling me a ladder, huh? You say some pretty interesting things. In a way, your misguided thoughts of what hope should be remind me of him. I don't really understand what you're saying.
Listen carefully.
Was he talking about Makoto? Anyway, I shall make a declaration. We will definitely destroy you. The hopes of all the Ultimates here will definitely, completely, utterly destroy you. There won't be even a strand of cotton left when we're done with you. That's your future. How much longer are you planning to say such stupid things? Don't you understand? Even Fuyuhiko died, you know? Not yet. He's still alive.
What?
Everyone!
Fuyuhiko is still alive!
You serious?
Frantically, we rushed over to Fuyuhiko's side.
He's still breathing!
Is he gonna be okay?
Do something! Hey! You need to save him! Hey!
I'm trying! But his blood, he won't stop bleeding out! His pulse is getting weaker!
Can't you do anything about it? God damn it!
Well, serves him right!
You're so stupid!
Were you filled with hope at the thought of saving her yourself? That's why you ended up like that?
You stupid brother!
What are you so laid back about? You need to hurry up and save him!
I don't!
A surprise order?!
What the heck?!
Why do I have to burn my precious calories just to save some Yakuza scum?!
That's wrong!
It's your duty to save him! Huh? Duty?
Hey!
Cause it's written in the school trip rules! If the only the blacking gets executed, then Fuyuhiko shouldn't be allowed to be executed. But he wasn't executed though. He literally jumped into his death. It was basically suicide. That's what Monokuma's gonna say. Well, if I could, I would do something about it right now. But since my magic stick was taken away, I'm practically powerless. But you should be able to do it. Jeez, I guess I have no choice.
Fine.
Well, there's no way I can violate a rule, even if it's me.
So?
Fine then, I'll save him. Really?
Like?
I was actually gonna do that all along, so I already prepared this. Mm-hmm. Prepared. And that's when it happened, the siren began ringing out of nowhere, and gradually grew closer and closer.
An ambulance?
Just leave the rest to me, Dr. Killgood.
Dr. Killgood, you've already killed your patients.
We gotta get this patient to the Monokuma Hospital ER and get him under 24-hour observation stat. So, I'll see you later.
After he said that, the ambulance containing Monokuma and Fuyuhiko vanished from our sight. Is it really gonna be okay to leave this to Monokuma? It can't be helped. It's not like there was any other way.
Perhaps.
He's gonna be fine. He's probably gonna get better and come back to us again. You're right. He's definitely gonna come back and talk a lot of smack as if nothing happened. Then all we can do is wait. Why do we have to wait for him? I mean, he caused Mahiro's death, you know?
However,
we must put that aside since Pekka has already been punished. Or else, we will not be able to advance forward.
Fall, my tears.
There are no second chances in life. We cannot return to what has already transpired. There is no other way than to move forward, like an arrow of light piercing through the darkness.
Damn it!
I guess things aren't as exciting if a crap stirrer like him ain't around. I didn't realize it, but I was wishing for that too. From the bottom of my heart, I really wanted him to return. Fuyuhiko! I don't want anyone else to be a sacrifice. And so the class trial ended. But we still can't see the real ending that we really wanted yet. When that finally arrives, what will have happened to us by then? No matter where I look, no matter what possibilities I look for, I can't see our future, not even a speck.
as if we were floating in a boat, floating unreliably in a vast dark sea. We were just left there alone. Only one word could explain our situation. Despair. We couldn't find a more suitable word than that. That's the end of the episode, guys. Man. I think I'm a sucker for, like, I'm a sucker for tragedy and stuff like that. Sad things, all of that. I'm a sucker for it, bro. That, when they was doing their whole little back and forth, Pekko and whatever his name is, I almost cried, dog. Like, I almost cried. Bro. I'm a sucker for that, but... Man, so far this is the best class trial I've played from this game and the last game. Peace out. I love you guys. If y'all enjoyed, like, subscribe, and tap into the next one. I can't, dang, man.